I got an inspirational message for those who say, I want to lose my accent. I want to talk like a native speaker. I want to sound more American, right? I have an inspirational message for you if you are somebody who has been struggling with your accent, right? I have an inspirational message because very often, you know, I release videos on my YouTube channel that talk about speaking, articulation, and communication. And invariably, in every single video I release, I have somebody commenting and saying, I want to reduce my accent. How do I get rid of my accent? How do I sound more native, right? I get variances of those questions. So today, what I want to share with you is a message. If that is you, and you maybe you are one of those individuals who commented, right? I want to have a message for you, right? And about accent, right? If you have been following me for a while, you would understand that I like my distinctions. Right, so when you say, I want to reduce my accent, or I don't like my accent, or I want to sound more native, the word accent actually comes from the Latin word accentus, right? And that the origin of the word accent is referred to a song that was sung along with music, right? So accent in its original definition was not about our pronunciation. It was more about intonation, pitch, tone, and intonation. And so you see, this gives us clues that accent refers to pitch, tone, and even intensity level of vocalization. But you see, fast forward hundreds of years, the modern day definition of the word accent has changed. It takes on completely new meanings, which is the case for a lot of English words, that modern meanings and definitions of words are completely different from what the original intention of that word used to be. Right, so now the word accent takes on completely different meanings, and the most common modern day meaning refers to the differences in the way someone pronounces a word in a language compared to native speakers of that language. And the most common reference to accent is in the English language. So when we say accent in the modern terms, we're talking about how we pronounce English words compared in a different way compared to native English speakers. And so it is referred to as accent. And so this usually, when we have this new definition of the word accent, it usually produces assumptions about somebody's nationality, but not always. Not always. It doesn't always assume about nationality. Sometimes it also produces assumptions about a person's social class or even their level of education. Right? But here's what I'll share with you when it comes to accent. Right, how you think about accent will determine how you speak. Right? Your perspectives about your accent and accents at large will also determine your clarity in which you speak. And therefore, it will also determine and it shapes and affects and influences your confidence levels. And remember what I shared with you, the principle about confidence is that people don't see you through your eyes. People don't see you through their eyes, they see you through yours. So there are three things that I want to share with you in terms of accent. The first thing is that accent is routine. What do I mean by that? When it comes to accent, right, the modern day definition of accent, it's about how we pronounce words differently compared to native speakers, right? And so pronunciation refers to everything, all of that refers to the mechanics of speech. Mechanics, in other words, how do you move your lips? How do you move your tongue? How do you move your mouth? How do you control your pharynx, which is the muscles at the back of your throat, which produces the sound, right? Tongue curling, how forward or back we place our tongues, how we pronounce specific sounds like th, r, th, or str, tr. Those things are all mechanics of speech, right? So accent is routine. Now, that does not affect our ability to be effective. Simply having a mechanics of speech, just simply focusing on mechanics of speech, does not improve your effectiveness in communication, right? However, the only consideration is your pronunciation difficult to understand? And most times, you know, 9 times out of 10, it is not, it may not be. And so this is important for you to have a very professional, a very clear elaboration, a very clear feedback on your pronunciation, because oftentimes we think that's what makes us effective. But again, 80-20 rule, 80% of what makes us effective is the strategies of communication, not the pronunciation of it, not the mechanics of speech. Mechanics of speech only makes up 20% of our effectiveness and our clarity of speech. So if you are somebody who recognizes this, if you got an aha from what I just said, that accent is routine, but you want to still improve your communications, you want to be more effective, you want to know the strategies, then I invite you to book a call with me. Below this video, you're going to see a link to book a call. And this is for a coaching and a mentorship moment with me below this video. And this is where I'm going to walk you through the strategy of communication, how to be effective when you speak. And it doesn't matter where you're starting from. I'm going to meet you where you're at so that you can make improved and measurable and experiential improvements in your communication. So if that's you, then I invite you to click the link below and I hope to see you on the inside. Right? So that is the first thing I want to share about accent, is that accent is routine. The second thing about accent is that accent is relative. It's relative. So you have been listening to my video for the past few minutes and maybe you're thinking to yourself, Dr. Grace, you don't have an accent. You don't have an accent, Dr. Grace. And some of you have been following me for some time and you know that I'm originally from Hong Kong. And a lot of you have commented on my videos to say, well, Dr. Grace, how did you get rid of your accent? How come you don't speak with an accent? But accent is relative. I have an accent. I have an accent. You see, for my master's degree, I went to Edinburgh. And Edinburgh is the capital of Scotland in the UK. So I went to Scotland. I moved to Scotland to study my master's degree. Every day, I was challenged to do presentations in class, to speak and meet with my classmates, to collaborate with other scientists. And a lot of them were from the UK, right? I was meeting a lot of locals. A lot of my friends were local from Scotland. And a lot of people in Scotland are from England, and they moved to Edinburgh for studies or to make a living. And invariably, every single week, I had locals comment on my accent. So you see, I have an accent because accent is relative. It is relative. There is no buddy that has no accent. It is literally a mechanics of speech because accent is routine and accent is relative. So when you say to me, Dr. Grace, I want to eliminate my accent, then my question to you is, you want to eliminate your accent in comparison to what? When you say, I don't want to have an accent, in comparison to what? Because accent is relative. It's relative. And the third thing I have, a message I want to share with you about accent, the third thing is that accent is relational. Accent is relational. And by the way, if you can really hear what I am saying and it resonates with you, then I invite you to give me a thumbs up and comment below. Comment below, what have you learned from this so far, right? And if you haven't done so already, remember to subscribe to my channel because every single week I release videos like this that help to take your career and your communications to the next level, right? So the third thing is that accent is relational. So what does that mean? So you want to say, so you're saying to yourself, I want to reduce my accent. Then my question to you is, to achieve what ends? To achieve what? You want to reduce your accent. What is your intention? What is your intention to speak? What is your intention to communicate? Is it that you want to fit in to sound like the locals? Right? Is it that you want to be more understandable? Is it something else? So to what ends? What is your intent? Start with the end in mind. Why do you want to reduce your accent? Right? If it is because you want to be more understandable, what are the reasons why you believe that you are not understandable? Is it, see, there's two things, there's two reasons. It could be because of pronunciation, or it could be because of delivery. If you are not understandable because of pronunciation, and again, it takes a truthful and honest feedback and evaluation of your speech to know if that is the reason. So if you are not understandable and it's because of pronunciation, then that is all focused on the mechanics of speech. However, if it is the latter and it's because of delivery, and again, I mentioned it before, it's 80-20, 80% of lack of clarity in communication is due to delivery. It is the strategy behind it. So you see, accent is relational. So these are three things about accent. First of all, accent is routine. The second thing, accent is relative. And the third thing, accent is relational. So you gotta decide, you gotta realize which one are you in? Is it pronunciation versus delivery? If it is pronunciation, then it's mechanics of speech. It is, if it's delivery, then invest in that coaching to show you the strategies to communicate well, to show you the structure and the syntax of communication, to show you the effectiveness of it, the deliverance of it, to make you clear, understandable, effective, and also persuasive, right? So if you are somebody who wants to get to that next level, then I hope to see you on the inside. Otherwise, if not, then subscribe to my channel, and I look forward to hanging with you again in my next video.